I think it's really important to emphasize that there is no one perfect all one size fits all response, but there are some characteristics that the most successful places share. They do better with leaders who are committed to facing facts, fears, and failures and able to adjust. It comes down to being data driven, to using information to continuously improve the response, and to fully supporting and being guided by public health. And as I look around these and other parts of the world, what I see are really a series of very important principles. One organized system, so that it's not every place within a country on its own. Even with the decentralization of Germany, they had one approach. Human contact tracing. There's been a lot of attention to digital products, but fundamentally, this is about disease detective work and building bonds and supporting people. Free testing with rapid results that are appropriately used. Support for patients and for communities. Fast action. Weeks, hours, even days can make a huge difference here. Just a one-week delay is the difference between a few hundred or a few hundred thousand cases in some countries. Innovation is so important, and we're seeing all sorts of innovations being done in real time to improve the response. Protection of the most vulnerable communities, whether it's the elderly in Germany or look in other places where more needs to be done to protect the most vulnerable. Clear communication, so there's one message. A data-driven response that is based on public health principles and a strong public health system at baseline. This is perhaps one of the key long-term lessons. We need to invest in the public health system so that it can address the problems of today as well as the emergencies of tomorrow.